So we are finally getting through Wyoming. We got caught in somewhat of a freak snowstorm that put us behind, as usual. But we are heading out of Wyoming and crossing into the Black Hills of South Dakota, a place I've wanted to hunt my entire life, and we're finally here. We're heading into Custer State Park. I have a buffalo tag, and we are meeting up with Chad Kremer, the man who knows more about buffalo than any other person on this earth.
So I'm Chad Kremer, the owner of Kremer Buffalo Company, and also in my day job, I'm the bison herd manager at Custer State Park. I've been at the park about 20 years and in this area, living and living the dream, I guess you could say, and working in the park. And the bison became my passion almost 30 years ago, and it's led me on a tremendous path over the years. And we've spent the last 20 years of that here in the Black Hills of South Dakota. Part of what I do over the course of the year at my job in the park is my main responsibility is the bison herd. And I have several folks that help me over the course of the year with that. But if you haven't heard about it, or you do know, we do the annual bison roundup, which is kind of the big event for the park for the year. So with that, we have about 20,000 spectators a year that come and watch that event. And then we will work the herd and go through that and take off our surplus for the year. And in our own operation, we're adjacent to the park on a few thousand acres, and we've been putting that together over the last several years. The area is very diverse, and there's a lot to do. You have Mount Rushmore is about 20 miles away. Crazy Horse Mountain is just north of Custer. The Black Hills is an area that's rich in a lot of history, a lot of hiking and outdoor activities can be taken in, you know, during the summer and through into winter. And in the park itself, there's great places to stay. We have the four lodges in the park. There's several campgrounds that people and families come and enjoy throughout the course of the year. With Kremer Buffalo, we're a small family operation, and we have three children and a son-in-law that are getting more involved with it. Getting to the point where we're building that up to be able to bring them in and participate in. As we go forward, they're going to become more and more involved with that. You'll be able to check us out at KremerBuffalo.com as we go along here and see what we have to offer for you, for the animals, and for the opportunities in the area here.
Fold, peel, stick, shoot. Get your targets at showinnovation.com.
Drinking milk is a great way to meet the body's needs for 9 essential nutrients and vitamins. It helps build stronger bones, maintain muscle mass, and it helps power us at Bone Cold TV to achieve greatness. Go to milkforhealth.org to learn more.
Bison down here about 2 miles. We have the elk up above us. It's warming up fast. We lost most of our snow already last night. There's animals everywhere.
trying to come out for lunch, and we are covered in bison crossing the road here. It's a giant herd of cows and calves and some really young bulls. That is so cool to see. There's no shortage for bison. Custer, South Dakota, that's for sure. That's incredible. That is the best traffic jam I've seen in a long time.
Okay. Look out.
So we're working on just covering as much ground as possible today. But it's really tough because every single ridge top we get to, we glass and there's more animals to look at. This place is incredible. Something about the hills of South Dakota. Look at this day, amazing.
The new Pro Series has a pile of really cool attributes to it, but my favorite thing is you go to this home screen, view from SD card, you can climb up in the deer stand while you're hunting and see what was on your camera right below your tree stand without having to go home and check your computer first. You can do it right there in the tree stand.
Sun is coming out. We are officially hunting, and we have the best possible scenario that we could have. One lone bull on this ridge top. On the other side of that ridge is just like this, big rocks, lots of trees, big canyons. We can definitely work with that. As soon as he gets up over that top, we're going. Down. Pretty badly in there. We should be able to see where that bison went. Three balls. About as far as you can see. That's not the bison we're looking for. I think the one we're looking for is over this ridge.
plains bison at 20 yards.
He's still right there. Look at this. Yes.
South Dakota, hunting bison. Never thought that I'd have the opportunity to do something like this. And I can honestly tell you, we've been around the world, and this is one of the most gorgeous places I've ever been to. You live in, it's paradise. I absolutely love it, so thank you. Thank you, I cannot tell you thank you enough. I'm unbelievably appreciative of this opportunity. Now this is the Plains bison.
Correct.
So, not to be mistaken, you know, I hunted wood bison last year in Canada.
Yep. Little bit of phenotypical difference between them. Most notably, the woods bison are typically framier, larger framed, and then the most distinguishing characteristic when you look at them is their hump.
Yeah.
The plains bison, the peak of their hump typically is right about the center line of the shoulder, so right in this area, where woods bison, their hump projects further forward, so the highest point on their hump is all the way forward before it drops off down to your neck. So,
you know, we're sitting here with probably one of the greatest views ever. Almost looks like there's some buffalo as far as you can see on that top ridge there, maybe.
Yeah.
Just amazing. We've seen hundreds and hundreds of buffalo over the last couple of days in Custer State Park. Just absolutely amazing animal. Oh, I'm so grateful. I cannot believe I'm sitting here behind a plains bison. Thank you, sir.
Hey, you bet.
No, I
pleasure.
It was amazing. Absolutely amazing.
Glad you got to come and visit us and see South Dakota.
It's incredible. I love it.
There is a reason why treason goes with us around the world.
It's our last day in New Zealand. We just came off the world's greatest spot and stalk hunt ever for alpine goats in the history of goat hunting.
Tell me when, guys.
Kill them. Yep.
Smoke, buddy, smoke.
Kill him. I'm on him.
So the weather continues to change drastically on us. We're into wind, rain, and even snow. Rachel has asked us to call some animals before winter really sets in, especially any and all of the goats. We're actually heading back to a spot where we kicked a bunch of fallow out a few days ago. We had no shot opportunity, but we're gonna approach it differently this time, see if we can't get in close.
Looking for management fallow, does, old bucks. Brandon's sprinting up this mountain. Me and Sean gotta catch up, but how can you stop to take this in? Our last afternoon in New Zealand. Beautiful, beautiful place.
6. We gotta let them separate. Big chocolate, clear in the middle.
Got him.
Which one is he?
Going down right there on the skyline. Beautiful.
Oh yeah, he's down.
Yes.
And that is it. That concludes our trip. Lethean Valley, New Zealand. We ended it on a high note with a great fallow. Look at these front points. This is exactly what Rachel wanted when she said go shoot us a management buck. This buck is huge, huge body. Definitely going downhill, and I am extremely happy. Weather's rolled in, it is cold. We didn't get much footage because we were trying to keep the cameras dry, but I am so extremely happy with this thing. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Thanks, Brandon. Thanks, Sean. Thank you to everybody.
Outdoors for Our Heroes mission is to help service-disabled vets build hope, confidence, and family strength through quality outdoor adventures.
Good job, guys.
Our wartime service-disabled veterans are facing many new challenges in life they have never anticipated. If you'd like to learn more about Outdoors for Our Heroes, our landowner that wants to host a hunt, or to find out how to help, visit outdoorsforourheroes.org.